Hello students, myself Nidhi Shabalia. Today I am conducting this session for grade 6 subject maths and this is our 7th session for the chapter Knowing Our Numbers. Now in our previous session we have studied about the concept of rounding of the numbers to nearest 10, 100, 1000, 10,000 and nearest lakh. Now in today's session let us continue with the concept of estimation. So students, in many situations, while dealing with numbers, we need quick and rough answer. That is, we need the estimated value. जब हम calculation करते हैं, addition operation or multiplication or finding out the difference between two numbers or dividing a number by another number, then we may need a quick and rough answer. That is, we do not need to perform the calculations using exact numbers, but at that time we can use the rounded off numbers, which are multiples of 10, 100, 1000, 10,000, lakh. So in that case, we are using the approximate numbers and the calculations will be faster. We can even do the mental calculations and we will get a quick and rough answer, which is known as estimated answer, estimated value, estimated number, which is near about to the actual answer, the actual value. So for example, if you are going to a stationery to buy a notebook and a pen, and you know that the cost of the notebook is 35 rupees and the cost of the pen that you want to buy is 12 rupees, then you can round off these numbers to the nearest 10. So 35 is rounded up to 40 and 12 is rounded down to 10. Now mentally you can add these two numbers, that 40 and 10 is equal to 50. So here you have the estimated cost. And over here, if you perform the actual calculation, the actual addition of these two numbers, then the actual total cost of both these items is 47 rupees. So over here, the number 50 will give you the idea that how much money you need to carry with you before going to the stationery shop. Now students, estimation also helps us to check our calculated answers. So over here, if we have to add these two numbers, that is 6731 and 4098, and if I make a mistake while adding the digit at 1000's place, 6 and 4 is equal to 10. So this is the actual correct answer, but if I make a mistake and write 2 over here instead of 1, then my calculated answer, which is wrong, will be 20,829. But if I round these numbers to the nearest 1000, then 6731, since the digit 7 at 100's place is greater than 5, so this number is rounded up to 7000. And over here the digit 0 at 100's place is less than 5, so 4098 is rounded down to 4000. Now I can add 7000 and 4000 mentally and that is equal to 11000. So if I compare the estimated answer and my calculated answer, then 11,000 and 20,829 have a big difference between each other, right? So I will get the idea that I have made some calculation mistake over here. And if you see over here, the estimated answer 11,000 and the actual correct answer, that is 10,829, are near about to each other. They are close enough to each other. So this way also the estimation can help us. Now students, let us have a look at the concept of estimating sum or difference by solving question number 5. So over here, we have to estimate the sum and compare the result with the actual sum. Now over here, we have to estimate the sum. So we have to add the rounded off values for these numbers and we have to compare the estimated sum with the actual sum. So over here, this number 34,253 is greater than 5,524. So this is the smaller number. Over here we have 4 digits. The highest place is 1000's place. So we will round off both these numbers to the nearest 1000. So rounding off both the numbers to the nearest 1000 . Now over here the number 34,253, if we have to round this off to the nearest 1000, we will look at the next place, that is the 100th place over here, and over here the digit 2 is less than 5. So we will replace the digit at 1's, 10's and 100th place with 0, and since 2 is less than 5, this number will be rounded down. So over here we will keep the remaining digits as it is. So 34,000, this number is rounded down to 34,000. Now the number 5524, if we look at the digit at 100's place, it is 5. So this number will be rounded up to the next nearest 1000. So over here, replacing the three places, these three places with 0, and adding 1 over here to the 1000's place. So 5 add 1 is 6. So this number 5524 is rounded up to 6000. Now the estimated sum by adding these rounded off numbers, the approximate values. So 34,000 add 6,000. Now 34 add 6 is equal to 40. So the estimated sum is equal to 40,000. Now the actual sum, let us find the actual sum. Actual sum is equal to adding these two numbers. So 34,253 add 5524. 3 8 4 7, 5 8 2 7, 2 8 5 7, then 4 8 5 9 and 3. So the actual sum is 39,777. So over here, continuing this question A over here, we have here the estimated sum is greater than, see over here 40,000 is greater than 39,777. So estimated sum is greater than actual sum. You can even write over here, therefore, this side. So therefore means as a result of the previous calculation. So estimated sum is greater than actual sum. 40,000 estimated sum is greater than the actual sum. Now here, as the estimated sum and the actual sum are close enough to each other, so as the estimated sum is close to the actual sum, our estimate is correct. Estimate means the estimated sum is correct. Now over here in question B, we have both the numbers as 4 digit numbers. So rounding off the numbers, rounding off both the numbers, to the nearest 1000, since the highest place is the 1000's place. So rounding off both the numbers to the nearest 1000 over here, so we have 2507, which is having 5 at 100's place. So we will round this number up to the next 1000. So replacing the three places, the last three places with 0, and adding 1 over here to the digit at 1000's place. So we have 3000. Then we have the number 3256. Now over here 3000. Replacing these three places with 0 and keeping the digit at 1000 place as it is. So the number 3256 is rounded down to 3000. Now over here, the estimated sum is equal to 3000 add 3000, which is equal to 6000, and the actual sum we have to add these two numbers, so 2507 add 3256. 7 8 6 13, 1 carry over, 1 8 5 6, 5 8 2 7, and 2 8 3 5. So we have the sum, actual sum, as 5763. Therefore over here we have this number, estimated sum greater than the actual sum. And over here both these sums are close enough to each other. So therefore, as our estimated sum is close to the actual sum, our estimate is correct. Now students, in question 5, C, D and E you will solve on your own. Now let us solve F over here. Now here we have both the numbers as 5 digit numbers. So the highest place over here is the 10,000 place. So rounding off both the numbers, so over here the number 19,877, for rounding this to the nearest 10,000, we have to look at the thousands place. The digit at thousands place is 9, and 9 is greater than 5. So we will write 4 zeros in the places from ones till thousands, and we will add 1 over here to the 10,000 place. So 1 and 1, 2. So this number 19,877 is rounded up to 20,000. Then we have this number 43,581. So over here we have to look at the place after the 10,000 place, that is the 1000 place. 3 and 3 is less than 5. So over here, replacing the 4 digits over here from 1 till 1000 place with 0, and keeping the digit at 10,000 place over here as it is. So this number 43,581 is rounded down to 40,000. Now finding the estimated sum. Estimated sum is equal to 20,000 and 40,000, which is equal to 60,000. Now the actual sum is equal to, adding these two numbers, so 19,877 and 43,581. So 7 at 1, 8, 7 at 8, 15, 1 carry over, then 8 at 5, 13, 13 at 1, 14, 1 carry over, then 9 at 3, 12, 12 at 1, 13, 1 carry over, and 1 at 4, 5, 5 at 1, 6. So the actual sum is 63,458. And over here, We can say that therefore the actual sum is greater than the estimated sum. And also over here 63,458 and 60,000 are near about each other. So we will write as estimated sum is close enough, is close to the actual sum, our estimate means the estimated sum is correct. So solve the entire question in your CW. Now students, question number 6 is related to estimating the difference. So the question is, estimate the difference and compare the result with the actual difference. So over here in A we are given two numbers and they are two 4-digit numbers. Both have the highest place as the thousands place. So over here rounding off both the numbers to the nearest thousand. So the actual difference is greater than estimated difference. This is greater than this number. And the estimated difference, 4000, is close enough to the actual difference. Therefore, as the estimated difference is close to the actual difference. Our estimate is correct. So over here, this estimated difference is close to the actual difference. So our estimate is correct. Now in B, over here we have the number 12,507 and 223. Now this is the smaller number over here, and the highest place of this number is the hundredth place. So rounding off both the numbers to the nearest hundred. So over here we have 12,507, and we have to look at the tens place. After the hundreds place, we have the tens place. So we have to look at the digit at tens place. Over here it is 0. 0 is less than 5. So we have to replace the two digits after the hundreds place with 0 and keep the remaining digits as it is, as we have 0 less than 5. So over here, keeping these three digits as it is, replacing the two places, last two places with 0. So the number is 12,500. Now over here we have this number 223, and the tens digit is 2, less than 5. So over here, writing 0 in the ones and tens place and keeping the digit over here as it is, so we have 223 rounded off to 200. Now the estimated difference is equal to 12,500 minus 200, which will be equal to 12,300. So over here we have the estimated difference. Now let us calculate the actual difference. So now 7 minus 3 is equal to 4. Then we need to borrow from here. So 10 minus 2, 8. Then 4 minus 2, 2. And so here we have the actual difference, that is 12,284. And we have the estimated difference. Now over here the estimated difference is greater than the actual difference. So writing that over here. Now over here the estimated difference is close enough to this number. So therefore thank you. Correct. Now students, over here in question 6, see, over here we have a 4-digit number and a 3-digit number. So, the smaller number has the highest place as the hundreds place. So, you will round off both of these numbers to the nearest 100. Next one, over here you have both of these as 4-digit numbers. So, you will round off both the numbers to the nearest 1000. The highest place is 1000's place, that is 1. Now, next one over here you have 3-digit numbers. So, 100's place is the highest place. So, round off both of these numbers to the nearest 100. Next one over here, we have a 5-digit number and a 4-digit number. This is the smaller number. So, the highest place is the 1000's place. So, round off both of these numbers to the nearest 1000. And solve the entire question. How we solve A and B? Solve the entire question in your CW book.